Hey everybody, welcome back to Band House Recordings. I just got done with a session up at Killington Bike Park. It was super fun. We're going to put that in a little video segment later, just in case some of you might be into that. You might not be. Who knows? I mean, this is technically a music channel, but, you know, we're just sharing what we like to do, you know, just on our own time too. Anyway, I wanted to announce to you all that we're going to start doing some more videos of mixing tutorials, some drum stuff, bass, guitar, and I just wanted to ask your opinion, what kind of videos are you interested in looking at? Today we're going to talk about some guitar stuff, and what I really wanted to talk about was, you know, thinking about guitar as more than just a riff machine, and more than just, like, the hooks for your song. Now, a lot of guitar-based music, you know, starting from way back when in blues and going up to AC/DC and whatever. Actually, AC/DC is a good example. You know, obviously the singing and some of the hooks and the singing and the songwriting is all fantastic, but a lot of AC/DC is really the guitar part and, you know, the riff that's been written, you know, like, bum, 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 you know, oh, that's Smoke on the Water. I'm an idiot. Deep Purple. I believe me, I know my music history. I'm just a little rattled from bouncing around down the mountain today. But anyway, so my point with that is, what was I thinking of? Oh, like, bum, ba-da-dun, ba-da-dun. You know, that's, everybody knows what that song is. And that's super awesome, but the guitar is such a great textural instrument. It's such a great, you know, I guess that's really what I'm trying to get at, is it's really great for texture. It's really great as an extra layer. You know, maybe you've got a synthesizer that's the hook or the vocal line, and just the vocal by itself makes it just kind of sound kind of boring. You know, guitar through a delay, through a reverb, or guitar through some sort of other modulation effect, you know, can just make a really nice pad. You know, I think bands like The Police and, you know, modern bands like 1975, like, you listen to those guys, there's some really cool guitar work going on there. Actually, best example would be The Killers, Dave Kooning. That guy is amazing. He's a huge influence on me. You know, there's stuff he writes, you think it's a synthesizer, it's him. Or you don't even notice it until you take it out. Like, some of the songs, even just like Mr. Brightside, obviously it has that really distinctive arpeggiated part, the right before the beginning, but then there's some other stuff he does in there that's just really cool textural work. So, you know, sometimes it's hard to do as a guitar player. For me, like, I just always want to be front and center, super loud, super crazy riff, but sometimes that, like, understated, angular, kind of more pad based stuff is really something that can really help the song. You know, it's like almost thinking about your role like a bass player. You know, sometimes a bass player just needs to play the root notes, even though they can do some really cool counterpoint and rhythmic work. Sometimes the best thing for a bass to do for that song is just to, you know, underscore or underpin is a good word of what everybody else is doing. And even though the guitar isn't filling in the bass range or the rhythm range necessarily, it can really underpin everything else and create a layer for everything else to sit on. Now, if you're in a band like mine, like with Sales or whatever, we have pads all over the place because we love reverb and pads, and sometimes the synth and the guitar interchange. You know, maybe you don't need a song where everybody's drenched in reverb or everybody's doing all that kind of ambient stuff, because then it's just boring and there isn't any rhythm other than the guitar, or sorry, the drums. So just be kind of mindful of that. Think about that. Excuse me, sorry. You know, we have some tutorials coming out that involve that, so that's why I kind of wanted to bring that up, see if that's something that you'll be interested in me going more in depth from, even though the video is coming out soon. I can do another video on that with kind of how we do our pads and how I approach that. And yeah, just let me know what you think. Don't forget to click on the notification bell, like and subscribe. Smash everything, share it with all your friends. Let me know what you want to see in the future. Thanks so much. This has been Bandhouse Recordings. We'll see y'all later. Bye-bye.